Hi, I'm Curtis Andre, the assistant equipment manager of the Toronto Raptors, and you're watching Colts TV.
On Colts, it's Liam Fowler here, joined with Ronan McQueenie.
With Don's recent dismissal, we're going to be taking over the show from now on.
So Kawhi's been in town recently, came back to collect his ring.
That leads us to a special feature from an ex-Carruthers student who dropped by with his good friend Larry O'Brien.
So let's check it out.
So I'm Curtis Andrade. I'm the assistant equipment manager for the Toronto Raptors and most importantly a former alumni of Bill Carruthers. I actually did a grade 11 co-op. From there, I worked for MLSC in office administration stuff. I got to know the head equipment manager at the time, and it was during the partial lockout year of the NBA. One day, he was just like, "Hey, do you want to be a ball boy?" You know, it's instantly, as a 16-year-old, I'm like, "Yeah, whatever you want me." So from there, I just stuck with it. I was leaving Carruthers and going straight to the arena for all the games, and then through, I went to Brock University, took sports management, and stuck with it. I came back for every game. 2.5 years ago, I got the opportunity to kind of switch over to Raptors all the time, and now I'm the assistant equipment manager. Day to day, I mean, we switch between it's either a practice day, it's a game day, or it's a travel day. A lot of my tasks are circled around Nike and our sponsorship and what the guys are wearing on the court, the shoes they're wearing. And then I do help out with some of the travel, and when I go on the road, I'll deal with all the equipment there. Long days, but it's great when it all comes together.
It's off to Leonard, defended by Simmons. Is this the dagger?
I'm kind of a very calm person, and in that moment, it was a bit of a jaw drop for me. I watched it go in, and everyone was kind of yelling and running around me, but I was just couldn't believe it.
Warriors just inbound, and that's it. There's a new NBA champion, and it's a team from Toronto, Canada. The Raptors.
When we were in San Fran, I was in the locker room, and it was kind of different because we've never been there. When Kawhi hit that free throw that kind of sealed it, it was a go, and you know. You're jumping between the moment of that just happened and it was kind of surreal. Like I know it's cheesy, but it was definitely surreal. In the moment, you don't realize what you're part of. I was lucky enough to bring my family, which means the most. We sat on those buses. I think it was supposed to be 2 hours, 2.5 hours, and it was 6 hours, I think, total. It was insane. Like, you'd look across the crowd and you couldn't believe that that's that many people just standing there watching us just drive by in a bus. So it was awesome. It was really well done. And it's one of those experiences where you're in the moment, you're like, this is, you don't even realize. Rugby was great because, I came into the school as a soccer player, funny enough, and then became a rugby player, and you create kind of a family with the teams you're on, and it became more of like a whole group thing, like even classes here, because that's how we all are as athletes. So, it's nice to have this here and it'd be kind of showy, but I just keep telling them, it's about how hard you work. And like that's where the Bill Carruthers aspect comes in. You get that hard work, you get that drive, and that's what brings us all together. And when you come here, this is what helps you kind of apply that.
What's up, Colts? Jake here. Today we're going to be talking to some students and see how much they know about Bill Carruthers alumni. We're going to give them 3 hints and see how they do. Let's do it. What's up, guys? Jake here. I'm here with
Nicole
and
Sabrina,
Kira,
Eric,
Curtis,
Chloe,
and
Jenna.
And today we're going to... What?
The microphone. Just
All right, and today we're going to be testing his knowledge of professional athletes that went to school at Crothers. All right, so I'll give you three hints, and then you have to guess who the person is. You don't even know? All right, who's the first person?
Oh.
Hint number one, they're of Romanian origin. Hint number two, plays tennis. And number three, they got a text from Drake and ignored him. Who do you think it is?
Bianca Andreescu.
Bianca Andreescu, I don't know.
Bianca.
Rafael Nadal.
That is incorrect. Want to try again?
Oh, it's Bianca.
Last name?
I don't know how to pronounce it. Andreescu?
There we go. First one done. All right, second one. Hint number one, plays for the Maple Leafs. They were picked 34th overall. And hint number three, 22 years old.
Wait, I know who this is, but I can't say it. It's at the tip of my tongue.
Do you know?
No, absolutely no idea.
Is it Padre? Wait, no, sorry.
Kadri? You think Kadri came from here?
No.
Not at all. I'll give you a hint. It starts with D.
Damien?
Make it really easy. It rhymes with Ermont.
Vermont?
If it starts with a D, how would it be Vermont?
D. No idea.
That's pretty easy. That has to be Austin Matthews.
Okay, the answer was Travis Dermott, but we'll go to the next one, all right? You probably will know this one. So, okay, hint number one, competed at the 2016 Olympics, competes in the 100-meter and 200-meter events, and is a Paralympic athlete.
Oh, Marissa Papa something.
Yeah, basically, yeah. Rhymes with Constantinou.
Starts with a P though, right?
Yeah.
Constantinou.
Well, you're almost there. Her name's Marissa.
Yeah.
Starts with a P. It's a long Greek name. Yeah. Who are you thinking?
Someone's trying to ask you a question. It's Marissa Papa Constantinou.
That is correct. Good job. Starts with Papa and rhymes with Constantinou.
Oh my God!
Popsantinou.
Marissa, yeah. Last name.
Something. It's Greek. It's Greek.
It's Greek. You know what? That's close enough. I can't even pronounce the name either. Oh.
It rhyme with that. You can stop.
It does. It does. Papa Constantinou rhymes with Constantinou.
Hey there, Colts. Next up, we got a young Canadian icon who's recently won a huge championship at the U.S. Open.
You probably know who we're talking about, Crothers' own Bianca Andreescu.
So we're going to send it over to Joseph Lagambina for a short feature about that.
She the North.
She the North, baby.
It's an extraordinary debut! Can you believe it? Bianca Andreescu is a US Open champion.
Hi, welcome to Colts TV. It's Joseph here with
Mr. Ruddle.
Today we're just going to be talking about Bianca Andreescu. So you made the mural about her. What inspired you to do that?
I wanted to paint something that was equally as epic as Wayne Gretzky. And we've been looking for a female Canadian athlete that is equally as awesome and historically significant. And I feel like because of Bianca Andreescu's success on the court and beating Serena Williams, she's sort of become a Canadian icon, and I think that that's one of the reasons why it's such a powerful image.
Would you say you're proud that a former Colt is doing something so special for the country?
Absolutely. I think it's amazing for our students, it's amazing for our school, but it's also amazing for all Canadians that we have an athlete who's as good as Bianca and who's sort of put her name down into the history books.
And what was your initial reaction when you saw her winning against such a good opponent as Serena Williams?
Well, my family and I watched the whole thing. I've got a two 2-year-old, a 5-year-old, and an 8-year-old, and we watched the whole thing, and they were cheering, I was cheering. It was just pretty amazing to have a former Colt to actually win the U.S. Open. I never taught her, but I totally think that she's awesome for the school.
Hey Colts, my name's Callie Wright. Yesterday I signed to the University of Memphis for Division I basketball. I had a lot of schools recruiting me, but the biggest thing was the coaches. They always supported me throughout, and my visit was amazing, so I couldn't thank them enough. That's why I chose Memphis. I'd like to thank all my coaches, my teammates, and definitely my family, my parents, and my little brother had a big impact on my life and my basketball journey. Hopefully I'll be on the world stage one day, and I'm looking forward to next year with Memphis.
Ronan, you ever been to New York?
Nah, I haven't.
Well, recently a bunch of Crothers students went there, so let's check it out.
The party never ends in a motel laying with my sins, yeah. I'm trying to get revenge. You'll be all out of love in the end.
Spent 10 hours on this flight, man. Told the pilot ain't no flight plans. Can't believe whatever I'm saying. And they know whenever I land. Bicentennial man, put the city on slam. She get trippy off Zans, lost 21 grams. And she did it on cam, wasn't no video dance. Make my own rules, I really don't pick, I just choose. I don't set picks, I just shoot. Shopping is screwed, I told her it's BYOB. That mean buy your own boobs, put it on God. He the one to put me on top. Can't be put in a box, gotta move on the ops. Never got the move on the drop. Tryna move on the sky and move that deep. Tryna run down, she deep. Gotta act a fool with the squad, next city no sleep. Back to the 713. Spent 10 hours on this flight, man. Told the pilot ain't no flight plans. Can't believe whatever I'm saying. And they know whenever I land.
I hear you're pretty good at dancing.
Yeah, I'd say so.
All right, let's see it then. That's just so bad, it's cringy, but good thing we got a dance class that can actually dance.
Well, let's see it then.
Good afternoon, Colts. I am here with one of our resident teachers, Miss Evans. I'm going to ask you a few questions about dance, okay?
Sure.
Would you say that Bill Crothers offers an equal opportunity for both boys and girls to be a part of the dance classes?
100%. The course itself in grade 10, 11, 12 is co-ed, so anybody is able to sign up for it. And it is, again, the opportunity is for athletes to learn a different style of movement and fitness that they're not necessarily used to or that their bodies aren't used to. It focuses on flexibility, coordination, agility, footwork. So any sport really that uses those different skills can benefit from taking this dance class. And it also teaches you a little bit of rhythm too, which isn't so bad at semi and prom and those kind of events, yeah.
So what you're saying is that dance is important to all of our sports.
100%. I mean, there's been studies of football players and soccer players taking ballet classes for that reason. It helps the footwork, balance, stamina, coordination. It's not just about like looking good or having some rhythm. It's actually about like the fundamentals of fitness. And it's a different way of using your body that not a lot of us are used to, because either we've never had the opportunity or maybe we're a little bit shy or scared to do it because of the stigma around it. But it's about just trying something different with your body and creating new muscle memory that can help you in other aspects.
Is there anything else you'd like to say to any students who are afraid to join this class and afraid to step up and be a part of it?
Step up. The course isn't about being the best ballet dancer or being the best dancer, period. It's just about fitness and teaching your body to do new things. If you're someone recovering from an injury and you want to focus on flexibility and rehabilitation, it's a good course for you. If you're someone that literally has no rhythm and you hear a song and you can't clap on the beat, it would be a great course for you. A lot of times, again, we get soccer players and basketball players taking the course for footwork and agility. You're teaching yourself how to change direction in air, on ground, and being aware of your surroundings and your space so that you don't run into the person beside you while you're doing choreography. And it's not just dance. In grade 10, it's a couple days of dance. We do body fitness, so like gymnastics, Pilates, calisthenics. We do cardio training, and then we do like a yoga stretch day. So it's not just a straight dance course. It's a body fitness course. And a lot of our students, I guarantee, would benefit from it if they gave it a chance and had an open mind when they walked into the door.
That's amazing. Thank you so much.
No problem.
We're going to roll some clips from our dance class. Let's go.
Baby, you know that I miss you. I want to get with you tonight, but I cannot, baby girl, and that's the issue. Girl, you know I miss you. I just want to kiss you, but I can't right now, so baby, kiss me through the phone.
Feels like a Christmas ornament.
Wait, is it gonna move?
No!
What is it?
You have to guess what it is!
Oh. It won't move!
Is it an animal?
No. This one is it.
Is it an astronaut?
An astronaut!
It feels like it's like a statue or something. Statue of Liberty?
Ew, that one moved.
Okay.
What? What? It moved. Are you kidding? Are you serious?
Did you
is it
like
wet?
No.
Go, go.
I don't know, you'll figure out.
What is that? Is it a bowl?
Look.
What's inside the bowl?
Is there water?
Uh-oh.
I'm scared. Oh my god.
Both things feel like scale. Oh, it's like candy or something? Like gummies?
Yeah.
Okay.
I can actually stop you. There's something in here. There's water. I'm not touching it.
Put it in! Look in, look in. Deeper.
I felt it. What is it?
It's a bowl.
Yeah, what's inside of it? Don't put the bowl
in. I'm wet!
What is it?
Let's go.
It's not gonna move, right?
If nothing moves in
this. It's not alive.
It, oh my god, oh my god. Is it cantaloupe? Like,
is it a worm? Is it a wet gummy worm?
Yeah. Oh.
There's any type of animal. Oh, it's a gummy.
He's gonna get it.
What kind of gummy? Gummy worms?
Yeah,
it's slimy. I feel like it's like oranges. Is it a worm?
Yeah.
Ew, run day!
Gummy worms.
It's a gummy worm.
It's a gummy worm.
Oh, I thought it was a real worm.
I think I'm just gonna go in right away. Like, just.
Just go for it.
I'm scared though. What if it's like spiky?
Whoa! Oh my god! What? It's like a skunk tail, man. What the?
It's a mic. Yeah, I felt it. I knew it.
I'm so scared.
Just squeeze it over.
Don't squeeze too hard.
Oh, I just heard something move! What was that? What was that?
It's pissed off now. I'm shaking that.
What is it? What the hell is that?
Watch the tail! Just don't touch the other side. Yeah, no, go back out. Yeah, there you go.
It's not alive!
You sure?
Is it a rat? Is it a cat?
Is it a cat?
Is it a
cat?
Is it a fish?
Yeah, fish.
Is it an animal? There's like plastic over here. I can feel the plastic.
Maybe that's the skin. The body.
I'm gonna throw it at you.
It's a hamster.
You're touching its ass.
Okay. Okay. Hold up.
You say you didn't want anything alive.
Oh my god, it's dead? Is it a dead hamster? It's a crab. It's a hair.
Liam, do you know what movie that was?
Of course, I love Frozen.
Not quite, but hopefully these guys know what movie that was.
It's not?
It's not the first one, it's not in the timeline.
We named him after your
central home. Endgame.
Avengers Infinity War.
Hello, Ron.
Yeah, good job.
The Anchorman.
Pirates of the Caribbean. It's Pirates of the Caribbean, Stranger Tides.
Wolf of Wall Street.
There you go. Cheyenne gets the point.
I'm sucking trash.
Hero.
I'm trash. Baywatch.
That's what I saw. Fast and Furious. Six. Right? Fast and Furious.
Seven.
Seven?
Let's go! Oh. Let's go!
He didn't even know what it was.
Oh, wait!
Man. Star Wars. I don't know.
Rogue One.
Rise of the Empire.
Rise of the Jedi.
Return of the Jedi.
Oh! I know it! It starts with an F. Force Awakens.
No way.
Let's go!
Avatar.
Oh my god. Saving Captain Ryan. Oh my god, I think
I know this one.
Rise of
I don't know.
No, I know it. I know.
It's that D-Day.
No, I know what it's called now.
Oh!
Starts with an H. Dunker.
Yes, that
Let's
was
go,
that's
baby.
The one.
Oh, I thought it was Dunkirk.
What is with you?
This is the real thing.
Transformers 3, Dark of the Moon.
Holy
guy, man. You watch too many movies.
This is Pirates of the Caribbean.
What the hell is this? Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings 4.
I don't know the name of it. I just know
Zelda.
It's Lord of the Rings. I just saw Gandalf.
Oh, it's the Hobbit. Let's go!
I did not get that.
Right?
Okay. Oh,
Hobbit was
Calvin Joyner. The Golden Jet.
Central Intelligence.
What?
Let's go!
It doesn't pass in peace.
Are you kidding me?
Star Wars.
Yeah.
Rogue One.
Oh, yes.
Star Wars Rogue One.
Alcatraz.
Venom.
I knew it too. I couldn't remember what movie it was.
Spider-Man Homecoming.
The Dark Tower.
I'm getting this.
Never heard of a character named Laura.
I know it. Yeah. The Winter Soldier.
Turn it around.
Turn it around. Wait till this way.
Logan.
Hey, if you like movies like these guys do, head over to room 3010 every Wednesday at lunch to check it out.
Colts, hope you're enjoying the show so far. Make sure you check out our social media platforms to stay posted.
That's what. Whoa, whoa, babe, poke it out, poke it out, poke it out, babe, poke it out, poke it out, poke it out, check it out, poke it out, poke it out, poke it out, new watch. Ice watch, check it out, new Glock, my Glock, poke it out, get out, showing up, baby, baby, poke it out, poke it out, poke it out, poke it out.
We invited you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. But to keep it unbiased, we removed all the badging and all the logos.
so you won't know what brand it is. So go ahead and take some time.
It's a Chevy Malibu.
That's a Chevy Malibu.
So go ahead and take some time, check it out, and let me know what you think it is.
It kind of reminds me a little bit of like an Audi.
That's a Chevy Malibu.
You're calling this an Audi? This ain't a sports car.
Seen the back, I would say Lexus.
Feels like a BMW.
Jahan, they call this thing a Beamer.
Jahan, what? This ain't a Beamer, it's a Chevy Malibu. Look at this thing.
The lines down here, the seamless, like classic German
like
design.
A BMW Tesla combination.
Cheryl, are you high right now?
I get it, it's legal in Canada, but not here, come on.
Let's look at the interior. It has keyless entry.
Ooh, keyless entry. My 96 Chevy S10 has keyless entry.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps.
Sorry, I didn't quite get that.
Siri, open maps.
I don't see anything connected.
Siri, open maps.
Here's what I found on the web for gorilla masks.
Do any of you have kids?
I do.
Yes.
Yes? This car has a feature built in called teen driver technology, which lets parents view how their teens are driving.
We'll keep track of how many boys get in the car.
Are we all laughing now because this guy's daughter has a little too much fun?
What price range would you put this car in?
50 to 65, I kind of like that range.
It leans more towards the $80,000 bracket.
Yeah, I wouldn't pay a dime over 15.5.
Well, what if I told you this is the 2016 Chevy Malibu?
This car's a
no
Chevy?
Way.
You know what, Gary? I hate you.
Gary, I hate you the most, but I hate all of you, especially you, Cheryl.
Yeah, Cheryl too.
Hey, Liam, you know what I hate more than 21 questions?
I don't know, 22?
A little bit higher.
23?
No, 73 questions.
It's actually 24 questions.
Well, who told me it was 73 then?
I told you, man. I told you.
Too much math. Let's just roll it.
Hey, Graham.
Hey, good. How are you? What's going on?
So far.
You know, usual day. Sun shining. Where else would we rather be?
Can we come in?
Come on in, join the party.
Just came to ask you a few questions. You ready?
That's what I'm here for. So
first off, what is your job here?
My job?
Yeah.
A lot of people ask that. I'm a teacher at Bill Crothers. I teach in the tech department.
Do you like your job here?
I love my job. So it's fun. Every day's a holiday at Bill Crothers.
What is your favorite part of the job?
My favorite part? Dealing with all these quiet, calm individuals on a day-to-day basis.
So how do you feel to be around all this equipment on a daily basis?
I feel very nervous because we're sitting on far too much money here, and I worry every day something's going to break.
So, one secret. Who is your favorite student?
My favorite student?
Favorite
well, of course, it's you. There's no other question, so.
So, how many classes do you teach, or do you just teach Colts?
I teach 3 classes, Colts TV and 2 tech design classes.
So, what is your favorite class to teach out of all classes?
Well, Colts TV is my favorite class, so, yeah, no, without a doubt, so.
So, describe Colts TV in one word.
Chaos.
If you had to convince students to join Colts TV, what would you say?
I'd say come join the chaos. That'd probably be the simplest answer. No, it's the fun part of the school.
Okay, so now I have some more rapid-fire questions to ask you.
Now I'm in trouble. So.
So first, Blue Jays question mark?
Yes.
Black Friday or Cyber Monday?
Cyber Monday. I hate Black Friday.
Favorite holiday?
Favorite holiday.
What's that?
Labor Day.
Favorite subject in school?
Wow, TV.
What song do you know all the lyrics to?
Oh, I know a lot of songs. Twist and Shout by the Beatles.
Is there a quote or saying that you live life by?
Wherever I am, that's where the party is.
Do you get out of breath when you walk up the stairs? Because I know I do.
Absolutely. One stair. So, not staircase, stair.
And if you could have one snack, what would it be right now?
That I can say in this camera? Yeah. It would be red licorice.
Okay, and then last one. This is really, I don't think you're going to get it, but wrong answers only.
Wrong answers only?
Wrong answers only.
Wow. Okay. So, see, you said I was going to get it wrong, so.
Okay, thanks for having us today, Graham. Thanks for answering these questions.
No problem.
Welcome to Colts TV. We are about to face off in a game of Box of Lies. Here's how the game works. Upstage are three mystery boxes containing objects no one has seen before. When one of us chooses a box, we can either choose to tell the truth or lie about the box's contents. The other will try to guess whether they are telling the truth or a lie. We'll play three rounds. Jake, choose first. Why am I looking at the back wall? Shit. Come on, Jake. You can do it.
Okay, so I just like explain.
Explain it to me. Explain it to me.
All right. So we've got a portrait here. This is a really nice portrait. I think it's of... Looks, it's Mr. Graham. And he's dressed like Bob Ross. He's got a beard and a big bushy, you know, Bob Ross hair. Some pretty accentuated eyebrows. And you can kind of see his chest hair.
What else is he showing?
Not a lot. He's got kind of a...
Oh, but you noticed the chest hair, eh?
Well, yeah. His face kind of says, you know, I might have done drugs.
Crossed man's up on the court.
I'm not gonna admit to it.
Alright.
It's kind of like this.
Okay, so Bob Ross is smiling like that.
Yeah.
All right, I think you're telling the truth.
Yeah, you're right. I didn't even know how to lie about this one. You caught me off guard. Sure. Okay, this is what it is. How am I supposed to lie about that? I can't even keep a straight face telling the truth.
Yeah, all right, put it away. All
right, I'm gonna pick, I guess.
Tells me it's your turn to pick. Oh.
I mean, there's two boxes. Either way.
Wait, this is rigged. I have to make up the lie or the truth twice?
Yeah.
Or is there four boxes?
Hey, I'm the host.
Kyle, you suck. Alright.
Oh my god. Alright. So, 9 out of 2. Okay. Wow. Okay. So, it's a picture of Kyle, like his head, on Lionel Messi. But he's in the bathtub. Nothing about this makes sense.
What else is in the picture?
Nothing, it's just... Well, I'm guessing it used to be Lionel Messi taking an ice bath. His thumbs are up.
What color is the bathtub?
White.
Is the water any specific color?
Clear.
Alright,
It has ice in it. That's why I specified.
When you said the floor was painted, what color was it painted?
White.
What?
Okay. That's just the tiles.
And it's just the tiles. I think it's true.
Nope. It's a Rubik's Cube with my face and your face on it.
Oh my god.
Bro, didn't you feel this? Alright, since I won, I'm gonna go pick another box.
That was the ceiling color.
Just as a victory lap.
Alright. I know,
What color is the ceiling? Fuck. All right. You ready for this one? I'm not.
All right, let's go.
Oh, yeah. This is iconic. All right. So, it's a cover of Mario Kart Wii, and it's got Steve Harvey and Dr. Phil on it.
Hey, what's Steve Harvey driving?
Have you ever seen the Mario Kart Wii cover?
I mean,
he just has a wheel in his hand. They're driving like invisible cars because there's like a shadow.
What? Wait, so this is an actual picture of like people playing the Wii game?
No, this is the cover.
Okay, tell me more about Steve Harvey. What's he doing?
Smiling creepily.
Okay. What is, what's his name? Not Steve Harvey.
Dr. Phil.
What's Dr. Phil doing?
Doing like a constipated face, I guess?
Two wheels. And then Steve Harvey and Dr. Phil.
Yeah, and I don't know if I mentioned this. Steve Harvey's Mario and Dr. Phil's Luigi.
Okay. I think you're telling the truth, because if you actually made this up, I'm just giving up on everything.
Hey, you got one.
Thank God.
And that's the end of the game. See you next time on Box of Lies.
What's up, Colts? It's Amaya here. Okay, so today I'll be going around asking a bunch of random people around the halls different questions. Let's see how everyone does. Okay, so just start off by saying your name.
Yes.
Who discovered gravity? Newton.
What?
Spell Mississippi.
MISSIPPI.
How many sides does a heptagon have?
Nine.
So, who discovered gravity?
I have zero clue. Probably Neil Armstrong?
Bruh.
How much dirt is in a hole that is 2 feet by 3 feet by 4 feet? Smash.
Wait, what?
24 feet volume, whatever.
Talented, brilliant, incredible, amazing.
What planet is closer to Earth, the sun or the moon?
Neither. They're both far.
Wow.
You're in a race. You just passed the person in second place. What place are you in now?
First. Wait, you were in a race, what?
You're in a race, you just passed the person in second place. What place are you in now?
First. Easy. First.
Okay, bye.
There's nothing better than playing a little pickup basketball at lunch to kill some time.
But doesn't it just drive you crazy when everyone's so extra?
Yeah, it does. Let's see what we mean.
Rita Breeze, we need a player for our team.
You in? You want to play?
I don't see why not.
Okay, gonna go. Yeah. All right, fellas, today we're gonna play some basketball.
Oh, my neck hurts.
Of course it does. All right, boys, today we're gonna be continuing our walk of basketball. We started?
My knee's hurt, sir.
I thought it was your neck yesterday.
New day.
All right.
My bad. My bad. My bad. My bad. My bad.
Give it a D. Put it up, put it up, put it up. What are you doing? What are you doing?
I drew Sal.
I drew Steve.
Look.
Oh. Jeez.
Whoa.
Good in the tail.
Yep, yep.
Alright, let's go.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my god.
Contact! What is this?
Oh,
no.
Well, Colts, that wraps up this episode of Colts TV. I hope you all have a happy holiday.
Stay safe.
Be happy.
Be jolly.
And we'll see you in 2020.